Good morning, friends. I am Dr. J. Satish Kumar, IQSC coordinator, Sri Vidyamandir Arts and Science College, Kateri, Ottangarai. In this video, we are going to see the criterion for infrastructure and learning resources. So there are four key indicators which carries 100 points in this criteria. First one is physical facilities, it carries 30 points. Second one, library as a learning resource, it carries 20 points. Third one, IT infrastructure, it carries 30 points. And finally, maintenance of campus infrastructure, it carries 20 points. Here, in first one, metric number 4.11, qualitative metrics. So in qualitative metrics, we should write maximum of 200 words. Here, the institution has adequate infrastructure and physical facilities for teaching, learning, namely classrooms, laboratories, computing equipments, etc. Here, we should write about classrooms. So what kind of classrooms with ICT enabled one? Language laboratories, library, computer lab, seminar halls, auditoriums, smart classrooms, virtual communication studios, restrooms, lift facilities. So these are all belongs to 4.1.1. So we write maximum of 200 words about this. The file description, upload any additional information, paste link for additional information. Next metric number 4.1.2. This is also qualitative metrics. Here, the institution has adequate facilities for cultural activities, yoga, sports and games. That means indoor and outdoor games, including gymnastic, yoga center, auditorium, etc. In this qualitative metrics, as usual, we write maximum of 200 words. Here, what facilities available for students and staff? Ways, availability of gym, indoor and outdoor games, yoga, availability of coaches. So what kind of sports the coach has appointed, annual sports day event, cultural activities. So what kind of cultural activities? Mention the students representing our college for university team, state team, national and international team, exhibiting the hidden talents, organizing programs. Also, students' participation in inter-college level and achievements, etc. So these all are belongs to this 4.1.2. We write maximum of 200 words in this criteria. Here, file description, geotagged pictures, upload any additional informations and paste link for additional information. Next metric number 4.1.3, this is quantitative metric. Here the number of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT enabled facilities. So the data requirement, number of classrooms with LCDs, number of classrooms with Wi-Fi or LAN facilities, number of smart classrooms and interactive boards, number of classrooms with LMS facilities, number of seminar hall with ICT facilities. Here the file descriptions are: upload the data template, upload any additional information. Also, the data templates, details of classrooms and seminar halls with ICT enabled facilities such as smart board, LMS, etc. In first one, we entered room number or number of classrooms, seminar hall with LCD, Wi-Fi, LAN facilities. In second one, we enter type of ICT facility provided. And final one, link to geotagged photos and master timetable. So SOP, that means standard operating procedure. In this metric, document required for verification, geotagged photograph of classrooms, seminar halls with ICT enabled one, specific instructions to higher educational institutions, only classrooms and seminar halls with ICT enabled facilities to be considered here. Not to be considered labs and workshops with ICT facility, not to be considered. So here labs and workshops with ICT facility not to be considered. Next metric number 4.1.4, this is quantitative metrics. Here expenditure for infrastructure augmentation excluding salary during the academic year 2021. So the data requirements are expenditure for infrastructure augmentation, budget allocated for infrastructure augmentation, year of allocation, total expenditure excluding salary. Total expenditure excluding salary. File description, upload the data template, upload audited utilization statements, details of expenditure, excluding salary, during the years, and any additional information. Here, in 4.1.4 and also 4.4.1, we use same data template. In 4.1.4, details of expenditure for infrastructure augmentation. In 4.4.1, details of expenditure incurred on maintenance of physical facilities and academic support facilities. Here, in first one, we enter budget allocated for infrastructure augmentation. In second, we type expenditure for infrastructure augmentation. Next, expenditure on maintenance of academic facilities excluding salary. Then, expenditure on maintenance of physical facilities excluding salary. And final one, total expenditure excluding salary. The SOP will be the document required for verification. Provide the consolidated fund allocation towards infrastructure augmentation facilities duly certified by the head of the institution. Highlight the relevant items in the audited income and expenditure statement duly certified by CA. And specific instructions to higher education institutions. Focus of this metric is on infrastructure augmentation only. So, infrastructure augmentation only. So, not to be considered. Avoid recurring expenditure on laboratory, expenditure on maintenance of infrastructure and acquisition of books and journals under this metric. Next key indicator, 4.2, library as a learning resources. Here the metric number 4.2.1, this is qualitative metrics. A library is automated using Integrated Library Management System, ILMS. Here, present a write-up maximum of 200 words. Now, we have to mention the name of the ILMS software, fully automated or partially automated, year of automation, versions. So what is the versions we are using, purchasing, everything we should have proper documents. File description, upload any additional informations, paste link for additional information. Next, metric number 4.2.2. This is quantitative metrics. So institution has access to the following: e-journals, e-South Sindhu, South Ganga membership, e-books, databases, remote access to e-resources, options. We should have any four or more of the above, any three of the above, any two of the above, any one of the above, and finally none of the above. So the data requirements are details of institutional memberships in other libraries, so details of subscriptions, file description, upload the data templates. So details of subscription like e-journal, e-books, etc. Upload any other additional informations. The data templates 4.2.2 and 4.2.3, both templates are same. We have to apply these two, 4.2.2 and 4.2.3, we apply the same one. In first one, library resources, how many resources we have. In second one, details of memberships, subscriptions. Third one, expenditure on subscription to e-journal and e-books. Fourth one, expenditure on subscription other e-resources. Next one, total library expenditure, and finally link to the relevant document. So the SOP, the standard operating procedure, document required for verification, e-copy of the letter of subscription, membership in the name of higher educational institutions. So membership in the name of higher education institution only. Screenshots of the facilities claimed with the name of higher education institution. Specific details in respect of e-resources selected. Specific instruction to higher education institutions. Ensure that the letters of subscription contains complete details. Provide a link in the institutional website for the selected options for verification by DVV. Finally, not to be considered, soft copy of printed books cannot be accepted as e-journals. Next metric number 4.2.3. This is quantitative metrics. Expenditure on purchase of books, e-books, and subscription to journals, e-journals during the academic year 2021. Data requirements. Expenditure on purchase of books, e-books. Expenditure on subscription to journals, e-journals. Month and year of expenditure. The file descriptions. Upload the data templates, audited statements of account, any additional information. SOP for this one, document required for verification, provide consolidated extract of expenditure for purchase of books and journals for the last year, academic year, for the last academic year, duly attested by head of the institution and CA. Audited income expenditure statement highlighting the expenditure for purchase of books and journals. Next metric 4.2.4. This is quantitative metrics. Usage of library by teachers and students. Footfalls and login data for online access. 4.2.4.1. Number of teachers and students using the library per day during the academic year. Here the data requirements. Upload the last page of accession register. Method of computing the per day usage of library. Number of physical users accessing the library. Number of users using the library through e-access. File description. Upload details of library usage by teachers and students and also any additional information. So higher educational institution is required to calculate the teachers and students usage of library per day. Average is equal to total number of students and teachers on every working day for all working days divided by total number of working days. So in this metric, data template is not applicable. SOP for this metric, documents required for verification. Certified e-copy of the ledger for footfalls for 5 days. Certified screenshots of the data for the same 5 days for online access. Specific instructions to higher education institutions. During DVV clarifications process, library logbook entries and data for online access for randomly selected 5 days will be asked during the assessment period. Here, randomly selected 5 days. Next key indicator 4.3, IT infrastructure. Here the metric number 4.3.1, this is qualitative institution as an IT policy covering Wi-Fi, cyber security, etc., and as allocated budget for updating its IT facilities. Here we write maximum of 200 words. File descriptions. Upload any additional informations and paste link for additional informations. So the IT policies documents like budget allocation for IT facilities, list down the number of computer labs, number of systems, networking equipments, hardware, software, language lab, Viscom studio, internet access with speed, ICT, firewall and antivirus, frequency of updation, etc. All such things have to disclose this up to 200 words. Next metric number 4.3.2, this is quantitative metric, student computer ratio. Here we write latest academic year, total number of students and total number of computers. So the number of computers available for students only. The computers for office and faculty will not be considered. And the file descriptions, upload any additional informations. Here, data template is not applicable to this metric. Metric number 4.3.3, this is quantitative metrics, bandwidth of internet connection in the institution and the number of students on campus. Options A, B, C, D, E. First one is greater than or equal to 50 Mbps, and last one less than 5 Mbps. Choose any one of the 5 options. So the file description, details of bandwidth available in the institution, upload any additional informations. Here the data template is not applicable to this matrix, but more than 50 Mbps will get good score, SOP. Bills for any one month one quarter of the last completed academic year, indicating internet connection plan, speed and bandwidth, and the higher educational institution name. E-copy of document of agreement with the service provider. Specific instructions to higher educational institutions: only leased line connectivity in the name of higher educational institution will be considered. Not to be considered: snapshot of speed test for Wi-Fi internet facility will not be considered. Broadband connections will not be considered. Next metric number 4.3.4. This is quantitative metrics. Institution has facilities for e-content development. Facilities available for e-content development: media center, audio visual center, lecture capturing system, mixing equipments and software for editing. Options: all four of the above, any three of the above, any two of the above, any one of the above, none of the above. File descriptions and upload the data templates. Upload any additional information. Paste link for additional informations. Here the data templates for this metric: name of the teacher, name of the module developed, platform on which module has been developed, date of launching the e-content, link to the relevant documents and facility available in the institution, list of the e-content development facilities available, provide link to videos of the media center and recording facilities. SOP. So document required for verification: geotagged photographs of media center, audio visual center, etc. Purchase bills for lecture capturing system, composing equipments and software for editing. Audited income expenditure statement highlighting the relevant expenditure. Specific instruction to higher educational institutions: list of e-content development, specific instructions to higher educational institutions, list of e-content developed by the higher educational institution. For large data, DVV will seek the link to the e-content from the provided list. Key indicator 4.4, maintenance of campus infrastructure. Metric number 4.4.1, quantitative metric. Expenditure incurred on maintenance of physical and academic support facilities excluding salary component during the academic year 2021. So the data requirements, non-salary expenditure incurred on maintenance of campus infrastructure, file description, upload the data template. So data template we have seen already, audited statements of accounts, upload any additional information, SOP, document required for verification, provide audited income and expenditure statement highlighting the items of expenditure incurred on maintenance of physical facilities and academic support facilities duly certified by head of the institution and CA. Specific instruction to higher education institutions, focus on this metrics is only on the maintenance of physical and academic support facilities, not to be considered mere statement of last year data on the metric without audited statement will not be considered. Metric number 4.4.2, qualitative metric. There are established systems and procedures for maintaining and utilizing physical, academic and support facilities, classrooms, laboratory, library, sports complex, computers, etc. So describe the institutional policy with the details of systems and procedures for maintaining and utilizing physical, academic and support facilities. They write maximum of 200 words. Creating a policies for institution creating a policies for institution should have maintenance committee to supervise the infrastructure maintenance, specific technical experts for maintenance and repairs of computers, different committees to take care of maintenance of garden, physical infrastructure, sports maintenance, library facility, canteen, parking zone. Each and every process have proper system. So file description, upload any additional informations, paste link for additional information. Thank you so much.